This video is based on the SARC smell optimization algorithm. In this video, we will try to understand what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, various steps used in this algorithm, and we have different mathematical models used in this algorithm for the position update, velocity calculation, and all. And we will try to understand how this algorithm is working step by step with numerical example. First of all, as you can see here, SARC smell optimization algorithm is a population-based meta-heuristic optimization algorithm that is inspired by the SARC food forcing behavior and by the sense of smell. And here you can see we have the certain key components used in this algorithm. First, you can see here we have SARC movements, forward movement, and rotational movement, and we have velocity calculation, and we have the target, or you can say the prey, as fish. So this algorithm is basically inspired by the food forcing behavior and by the sense of smell in the SARC. So first we will try to understand what is the food forcing behavior and how all this happen in the nature, so that we can easily understand how this algorithm is working. First of all, you can see here we have SARC. SARC is considered as the oldest creature on the earth, and it is also said that they also exist before the existence of dinosaurs, and they can eat all type of fishes from small size to the large whales. And you can see here variety of fishes they can eat. And you can see here we have senses: hear, smell, and sight. Hearing and sight is used to detect the prey, and sense of smell is considered as the major sense used by the SARC during hunt, and they can even smell the blood in the water. Due to their keen sense of smell, they can smell the blood in the water. You can see here we have the olfactory bulbs. They are used for smell information processing. SARC have large olfactory bulb located in their forebrain, or we can say they are connected to their brain, and they can receive the neural input about the odor detected by the cells. For example, you can see here while the SARC swim in the water, water flow through their nostrils and water enter the olfactory pits, and they can even detect the one blood drop in the water. So once the target is detected by the SARC, they stalk the target before kill. Now you can see here we have the various steps used in this algorithm. First, we will initialize all the important parameters, and then we will initialize the population for the n SARCs and evaluate their performance using cost function, and then check the stopping criteria, update velocity, position, evaluate the performance for the new solution, and after that, when stopping criteria is met, they will display the best solution found. So first of all, you can see here algorithm parameters. For the simplicity, we will consider the population size 3. So we have 3 SARCs in the search space. Maximum iteration we have 10. Current iteration right now is 1. Bounds you can see here minus 10 to 10. Time interval is 1. Dimension is 1. Inertia coefficient is uniformly distributed random value within the domain 0 and 1. And now you can see we have the position for the 3 agents in the search space that is randomly distributed values. You can see here this is for the first SARC x1. You can see this is the position for the SARC, this one, and for the second SARC value you can see this one. After that, using cost function, we will evaluate the performance for the each SARC. So this is the cost function that we are using here to evaluate their performance. So using cost function, you can see here we have the fitness values for the three sarks, and this one is considered as the best among all. After that, you can see right now we are in the first iteration. Check this condition, current iteration is 1, maximum we have 10, condition is true. Now we will enter inside the main loop. So here we will calculate the velocity for the each agent. So as we are in the first iteration, we can either neglect the initial velocity or we can assign a very small value to each agent. Right now we will consider the velocity as 0. After that, we will calculate the forward movement for the shark using this equation. Here, I is the individual, that is we have 1 to 3, k is the current iteration, and this is the position for the individual and the velocity, and this is the time interval. And for the simplicity, we will consider the time interval 1. After that, you can see here the forward movement calculation for the first agent. Here you can see position for the first agent. In the first iteration, we have 3.0816. Put the value here. Velocity we have 0. And time interval we will consider 1. And we got the forward movement position for the first agent as this one. And like that, we will calculate the values for the each agents. And then using cost function, again, evaluate the performance. And we got values here for the each agents, you can see. After that, we will calculate the rotational movement for the shark using this equation. This is the position for the shark that we computed in the previous steps. Here, this is the forward movement for the shark. R3 is the random value, and this is the forward movement. And you can see the forward movement position we have for the first individual is 3.0816. Right now I'm doing this for the first agent, random value, and again. So we got the rotational movement for the first individual as this one. Like that, we will do for all the agents, and we got the new position for the rotational movement, you can see here. After that, using cost function, again evaluate their performance, and we obtained the new cost values for each agents. Now we will calculate the shark new position. Using this equation, we will calculate the shark new position. Shark new position is based on the two movements that we did in the previous two steps. That is, the new position is based on the forward movement and the rotational movement. As you can see here, for the first agent, we have the, here we can see this is the OF means objective function value for the forward movement for the first individual is 9.4961, and the objective function value for the rotational movement for the first agent, we have this one. So right now we will consider the maximum value Y. So as you can see here, simplicity of this algorithm, we have certain assumptions. As you can see here, we have the target as the injured fish. So we will consider the target, that is the injured fish, as fixed, as it is injured and its velocity can be neglected as compared to the shark movement. Second assumption is, as you can see here, the blood is continuously injected into the sea. Therefore, the blood odor particles are considered higher near the injured fish, or you can say near the target. And one injured fish means one odor source in the search space. In the real life, we have C, and here we have the third space. So right now we are going to consider the next position for the sarc. We computed the forward movement and the rotational movement. Now we are going to update the final position that is based on the forward and rotational movement. So we will consider the higher order concentration, order particles. So right now, for this, we will use the maximum value that is here in the rotational movement, 16.9467. And so this is the position for the first sarc. Like that, we will update the position for the three agents, and you can see their cost and best among all. Now increment the counter, and you can see current iteration is now 2, and right now again condition is true, so we will again enter inside the loop. So now we will calculate the velocity. As in the previous iteration, we neglected the velocity, but now in the second iteration we will calculate the velocity for the each agent. So this is the velocity formula that we can use to update the velocity for the each sarc in the each dimension. This is the coefficient. Here you can see we have the coefficient, and this is the rate of momentum, or you can say the inertia coefficient, and value for both we have the 0 and 1, in between 0 and 1, and this is used to indicate the higher inertia. And we have the random values r1, r2, and you can see the velocity in the previous iteration, and we have the gradient of objective function, and we can calculate the gradient. Now for the first agent, we will calculate the velocity. So put the value here, we have the random value, and you can see the gradient of f means that we have the direction. So this is basically used for the direction. So here we will neglect the personal best cost from the global best and divide the total by the global best, and then you can see again we have the random value, and again random value, and you can see this is the velocity that we computed in the first iteration, that is 0. So put all the values here. Right now you can see the global best we have first agent, and so right now you can see the global best we have first agent, and its personal best is also this value. So we got the velocity for the first agent 0. For the second agent, put all the values, and right now in this case the global best is first agent, and its personal cost is 53.98.57, and we got the velocity for the second agent as 0.1473, and the velocity for the third agent as 0.0664. So we computed the velocity for the three agents. Now we will calculate their movements, forward and rotational, and after that we will update their position in the search space and again evaluate the performance. And we will repeat the loop until the stopping criteria is met, and once the stopping criteria is met, display the best solution that you obtained in the previous iteration. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.